Good morning, students. I am Mihir Sarkar, assistant professor of Siliguri Torai B.Ed. College and Siliguri Primary Engineering College. Today, I will discuss DLED English, Unit 10, Developing Tools of Assessment. First of all, what is classroom assessment? An assessment is a systematic process of gathering information about what a student knows, is able to do, and is learning to do. Assessment information provides the foundation for decision making and the planning for instructional learning. Assessment is an integral part of instruction that enhances, empowers, and celebrates student learning using a variety of assessment techniques. Teachers gather information about what the student know and are able to, and provide positive, supportive feedback to the students. They also use this information to diagnose individual needs and to improve their instructional program, which turns help the students to learn more effectively. Assessment must be considered during the stages of instruction when learning outcome and teaching method are being targeted. It is a continuous activity, not something to be dealt with only at the end of unit of the study. Students should be made aware of the expected outcome of the course and procedure to be used for assessing performance relative to learning outcome. Student can gradually become more active and involved in the assessment process in order to develop the lifelong learning skill. Evaluation refers to the decision making which follow the assessment. Evaluation is a judgment regarding the quality, value, or worth of response, product, or performance based on established criteria and curriculum standard. Evaluation should reflect the intended learning outcome of the curriculum and can be consist with the approaches used to teaching the language in the classroom, but it should be sensitive to differences in culture, gender, socio-economic background. Students should be given opportunity to demonstrate the full extent of knowledge, skills, abilities. Evaluation is also used for making decision related to such things as students' promotion, awards. Diagnostic assessment may occur at the beginning of the terms of unit study, or whatever the information about the prior learning of a student is useful. Various type of diagnosis assessment test, journals, performance-based assessment may be used to collect that information. Teacher may use diagnostics information assessment to, number one, find out what the student know and can do, identify the student's strength and plan instruct which builds on such extent. Number two, target difficulties. Identify the precise nature of them, instruct to meet those difficulties and plan. Number three, make informed decision regarding where to focus the time and effort. Number four, where to focus the instructional formative assessment, similar to a diagnosis assessment, is that provides on going feedback to the teacher effectiveness of instruction. Formative assessment encourage a variety of encompass variety of strategy used to select to accomplish one or more into the following purpose. Number one, monitor the student learning and provide feedback to the students and parents. Number two, identify the areas of growth, motivate the student and provide incentive. Number three, pay attention and effort, and emphasize what is important to learn. Number 4, provide practice in applying demonstration and extending knowledge and skill and attitude. Number 5, encourage goal setting and monitor achievement goals. Reflect. Number 6, reflect on program structure and effectiveness and modify or adjust teaching as necessary. The summative assessment occurs most often at the end of the unit study. The primary purpose are to determine knowledge and skill and attitude that have been developed over the period of time. To summarize the student progress, the teacher's role of assessment in the classroom. What is the teacher's role of assessment in the classroom? Teachers are primarily assessor of the student. Teacher design the assessment tools with two broad purpose. What are they? Number 1, to collect information that will inform the classroom, instruct and monitor the student's progress towards achieving year-end outcome. The teacher also assists students in developing self-monitoring and self-assessment skill and strategies. Number 2, to do effectively, the teacher must ensure that students are involved in setting learning goal, developing action plan, using assessment and process to monitor the achievement of the goal. Teacher also creates opportunity for the students to celebrate their progress and success. Teacher learn about the students' learning and progress by regularly and systematically observing the students in action by interaction with them during instruction, because the student knowledge and many of the skills, strategy, attitudes are internal process. Teacher gather the data and make the judgment based on observing assessment, students' interaction, performance and product. With example, teacher demonstrate the assessment, an essential part of the learning. They model effective assessment strategy and instruct the students in the developing assessment procedure, such as creating checklist. Teacher also collaborate with the parents, with colleagues regarding the student's assessment. Now, what is the guiding principles of assessment and tools of second language learning? Classroom-based assessment provides regular feedback and allows teacher student and reflect in progress and adjust instruct accordingly. See the chart entitled Principle of Assessment, Inform Instruction. When the planning for assessment for second language learning, it is important to consider the following points. Number 1, teachers should use variety of assessment technique that clearly reflect the communication, learner-centered, task-based approach and to the second language learning. For example, when we use task-based approach, written interaction would be tested by having students use the information written text out, and rather than by having the student answer comprehensive question. Number 2, the percentage of the final marks are allotted to each components of the curriculum should reflect amount of time the student spent the component. For example, if a student spending 70% of time oral activity, 70% of their final mark should be determined as oral evaluation. Number 3, test should be measured what they are the measuring for. For example, if a student are being tested for oral interaction or interpretation, test required that write down the information they have understood. They should be marked on whether or not they are understood, whether the information is written correctly spelled. Number 4, evaluation should be placed in context of meaningful activities. For example, grammar point deals with the course. A unit can be evaluated by looking at whether or not in the fill in the blanks. Number 5, different kind of outcome should be evaluated in the different ways. For example, knowledge related learning outcome can be assessed by objective test. Attitudes are better assessed by. Number 6, student should be involved in determining the criteria that will be used for evaluating their work. This can be a part of planning process. At the beginning of each unit, students should have a clear idea. This much for today. Thank you.